Microservices framework comparison. Spring Boot versus Quarkus versus Micronaut versus Jakarta EE. Welcome.
We're planning to modernize our monolith, and I'm a bit overwhelmed by the options. Could you help me understand the key differences between Spring Boot, Quarkus, Micronaut, and Jakarta EE?
Let's break this down systematically. Tell me which aspect you would like us to explore first.
Well, let's start with what makes each framework unique. What's their main selling point?
Great question. Each framework has its own strengths. Spring Boot is like the established veteran. It's mature, has massive community support, and provides everything out of the box. Its main strength is the huge ecosystem and proven track record. Think of it as the safe choice with the largest toolset. Quarkus is the modern challenger, focusing on cloud-native development and incredibly fast startup times. It's specifically designed for containerized environments and serverless applications. Red Hat backs it, which gives it enterprise credibility. Micronaut is the innovative newcomer that was built from the ground up for microservices. Its killer feature is compile-time dependency injection, which means minimal reflection and faster startup times. Jakarta EE, formerly Java EE, is the standardized enterprise platform. It's vendor neutral and focuses on stability and backwards compatibility.
Interesting. But how do they perform in terms of startup time and memory usage? That's crucial for our microservices strategy.
This is where it gets exciting. Let me share some typical metrics.
Those differences are significant. But what about developer productivity and learning curve?
That's where things get interesting. Let me break it down. Spring Boot has the gentlest learning curve if your team already knows Spring. The documentation is extensive, and you can find solutions to almost any problem on Stack Overflow. Here's a simple REST endpoint in Spring Boot. Quarkus has excellent developer tools, including dev mode with live reload. Here's the same endpoint.
What about cloud-native features and container support?
This is where the newer frameworks really shine. Quarkus is built for containers from the ground up. It supports GraalVM native images out of the box and has excellent Kubernetes integration. Micronaut also has first-class container support and can generate native images, though the process isn't quite as streamlined as Quarkus. Spring Boot has good container support through Spring Cloud and has been improving its native image support. Jakarta EE depends more on the implementation, like Pyara or OpenLiberty, but generally has good container support.
And what about dependency injection and testing?
Each handles it differently. Spring Boot uses runtime reflection for dependency injection, which is well understood but impacts startup time. Testing is comprehensive with at Spring Boot Test. Micronaut does dependency injection at compile time, which is faster but can make debugging more challenging. Here's an example. Quarkus uses Arc based on CDI, but optimized for fast startup. Testing is similar to JUnit with the @Quarkus test annotation.
What's your recommendation for a team transitioning from a monolith to microservices?
If you're coming from a Spring background and don't have extreme performance requirements, Spring Boot is still a solid choice. The familiar programming model will help your team be productive quickly. If you're starting fresh and want to be cloud native from day one, I'd seriously consider Quarkus. Its developer experience and performance are outstanding. Micronaut is excellent if you need the performance but want something more traditional in terms of programming model. Jakarta E might be the right choice if you need strict standards compliance and vendor neutrality.
This has been incredibly helpful. One last question, what about reactive programming support?
All of them support reactive programming. Spring Boot has Project Reactor. Quarkus uses Mutiny. Micronaut supports Project Reactor and RxJava. Jakarta EE has microprofile reactive streams. The main difference is in the programming model and how well it's integrated with the rest of the framework.
Thanks. This really helps clear things up for our architecture decisions.
You are welcome.